Are you tired of the internet speed being so slow that your granny could literally win a marathon while the web page loads? Are you bored and want to watch a movie, but the internet speed isn't good enough? Are you tired of waiting for the signals or moving around within the house to get good Wi-Fi signals? If your answers to all of these or even a single one of these questions is yes, then this video is going to be perfect for you. The future is here, and enough with the local low-speed internet services. It is the age of technology, and a slow internet is the last thing you would want in life. With everything from calling a taxi to ordering food, from calling a loved one 1,000 miles far, to finding out the results of your exams within minutes, the internet has become a crucial part of our daily lives, perhaps something that we can't probably live without. With everything depending on the internet, we can't even risk going somewhere with no service available. A solution has been proposed for this problem of high demand for the internet. Say hello to Starlink Global Internet Service, a way out to all of your problems. This is According to Science, and today we are going to tell you all you need to know about SpaceX's latest project, Starlink. From the basics to facts and figures, we will tell you all about it. Stay tuned to find out everything you need to know for the future. SpaceX has managed to make it to the headlines a number of times in history, such as the one back in 2012 when the company launched its Falcon 9 rocket into space with an unmanned capsule. The vehicle held supplies worth 1,000 pounds for the astronauts stationed in the space and was sent to the International Space Station, marking the first time a private company had sent a spacecraft to the International Space Station. Moving on to Starlink. This is a satellite broadband that would have latency of about 20 milliseconds, making it a lot faster than the cable internet that uses optic fibers to send signals, making it suitable for online gaming applications, which means it would have capacity to watch high-definition videos and play online games without the user noticing speed issues. One of the major hurdles that come in the way of setting up good internet in rural areas is the process of digging up the ground, setting in the cables, and dealing with property disputes, etc. However, Starlink satellites will work by sending beams of internet signals directly to a gateway or user terminal on the ground. That means there's much less infrastructure needed to get that internet signal to rural homes, making the process of availability quicker and neater. Starlink is supposed to deliver high-speed broadband internet to even locations where access has been unreliable, expensive, or completely unavailable, such as the middle of nowhere, on a desert or mountain peak. This means you can go on hiking and exploring the world without the fear of not being able to find help because there was no signals. The best part about this internet is that no government can control the access to this internet, which means all websites or apps will be available everywhere. For example, YouTube, Google, Facebook, Twitter, and many more apps that have been banned at the Great Wall of China will no longer be unavailable to the users there. However, for high-density areas like busy cities, Starlink is not supposed to replace the internet available there as it doesn't have sufficient bandwidth. The purpose of Starlink is to improve the connectivity between the rural and urban areas, but how will it work? SpaceX launched the first batch of 60 satellites packed on top of each other in a capsule which opens up once they are in space. In May 2019, followed by another payload of 60 satellites that very year in November. Even though this venture took place for the startup of the Starlink venture, but the appearance of hundreds of these bright orbiters in the night sky, with the potential of thousands more to come, worried astronomers who felt that such an abundance of satellites would increase the difficulty of studying distant objects in space, as that would cause light pollution. Therefore, to overcome this issue, SpaceX launched the recent batch with a sunshade that would block the reflections from the sun in order to reduce the light pollution in space. Even though 1,000 satellites would be more than enough to provide the basic requirements, SpaceX intends to send at least about 12,000 satellites into space, which are supposed to be space-friendly as they weigh only approximately 260 kilograms. Each Starlink satellite is about the size of an average office desk that will depend on ground terminals or gateways to bring internet into your home. Musk said they look like a small to medium-sized pizza, which led to the internet calling these terminals and gateways pizza boxes. The terminal is going to look like a UFO on a stick, which would be easy to use with two basic instructions that we know of, like plug in a socket and point at sky. The service is said to target American and Canadian areas for 2020 and is expected to expand to other areas later on. As of June 2020, 540 satellites have been launched into space, and they have acquired the permission to send up to 42,000 satellites into space. Well, they won't exactly send that many, but the purpose of sending so many satellites is to keep the quality of the internet maintained. Since these satellites will be so close to Earth, they can't stay stationary and will be on the move 24/7 and cover a smaller area. So, to make sure we get maximum internet coverage, a high number of satellites will be required. Each satellite has 81-degree range of view with an orbit of 550 kilometers, so each satellite can cover up to 500 kilometers of area. The cost of each terminal is expected to be anywhere from $100 to $300, but it's not clear who will pay that cost or if there will be a monthly rental fee instead of an upfront payment. The company has not made it clear the amount of money required for the project, but it has estimated to generate a revenue of $30 billion, which is 10 times more money earned than the rocket launch business. The cost of switching from 4G to 5G internet would cost $150 billion in terms of optic fibers over 7 years. But SpaceX is capable of finishing its entire Starlink project in as little as $10 billion. SpaceX has a lot of competition in the field of internet, but it is without any doubt ahead of the game because the company doesn't depend on rockets from other sources as it has its own rockets, which brings down the cost of each launch. As for latency, well, latency is the time it takes for your internet signal to travel from your computer to your ISP, to the website server, and back to you. So it is important that the satellite that is sending the signals is closer to Earth because lower the satellite, lower the latency. An average internet satellite takes a good minute to respond to the signal that has to travel 22,200 miles to reach the satellite, then back down to the website server, back up to the satellite, and back to you. This is why the internet's latency is typically between 500 and 600 milliseconds. However, Starlink satellites will sit at about 342 miles above the Earth's surface, which is much closer than other satellites, which means there's much less distance for your internet signal to travel to a Starlink satellite. This height will be achieved by the help of ion thrusters using krypton as a propellant, which would be cheaper than xenon. These space-friendly satellites are designed to minimize the space debris, which means that upon returning to Earth once their purpose has been served, these satellites will burn up to 95% with only the ion thruster's internal structure and silicon carbide components having a chance of survival. The purpose of the silicon carbides would be to allow using laser to transmit light impulses to trade information between satellites for sending signals, and since it'll be a quick way to transmit signals in vacuum, this will further lower the latency. However, there is a bigger purpose of this entire project. Elon Musk believes in improving the sustainability of life and believes that Earth will soon die because of the current global warming and extreme climate changes. The money generated by this project will be used to build a society on Mars, and the satellites will be used there too. So this is not just any other internet project. It's a piece of a bigger puzzle that we aren't fully aware of yet. If you liked this video, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to stay up to date with such interesting future videos.